Now's our time. We're uncaged.
Welcome to Topple Uncaged. I'm Steve Topple, and you're locked on to the UK's hottest politics and music podcast. Each week, I bring you the rawest takes on the big stories making the news, always joined by a very special guest. Then, I pleasure your mind, body, and soul with the freshest, most banging international music going.
Uncaged.
Ram dam 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 da. Have you seen this one? Well, you seen it though. Boom, bam, bam, no, it's another one. No apologies, just at least on the microphone. Boom, bam, bam, no, Skylar or King. Yeah. When jazz is calling, I was born and grown in a Kingston city. I said with pride if you ask where I live. Hey, hey. No, I don't care what they say. Yeah, we stress, but we bless anyway.
So my guest on today's show is yet another rising star coming from Jamaica. However, she is one of my kind of rising stars in terms of that she is already proving to be musically eclectic just in her first two tracks. She has got this stunning, stunning voice which effortlessly flips between styles, and both of these songs she has released so far have been powerhousing tracks. Absolutely fantastic, really, really top quality production, top quality vocals from this young lady, and really, really strong lyrically as well. I'm really, really excited about this artist because I think listening to her voice, listening to her musicality, and also what she's coming with, I think she's going to blow up. Fingers crossed for her. So it's a great privilege to be able to welcome her to the show for the first time. It is the fantastic Jazz Elise. Jazz Elise, thank you so much. Hello.
Thank you for having me. What a wicked, wonderful introduction, man.
It's all true, Jazz. It's all true. I am really excited. I think you're great. I'm really, really, you know, I hear artists all the time and I'm constantly doing interviews and I constantly get sent stuff. But I picked you up on my Instagram because there's lots of other artists promoting you at the minute. I've seen Savannah tweeting about, Instagramming about you, rather. Lila Ike, I think, has. Lots of people are talking about you and there's this little buzz surrounding you. And I was like, yeah, she's fab. We need to have her on. So thank you for coming on. It's great to have you here.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really excited. This is my first Skype interview vibe. So next time I'll come up there and sit down and talk to you.
Ah, excellent. Well, I'll hold you to that. That's already going in the diary. Excellent.
Of course.
No, it's really, really good to have you. I'm really excited to speak to you. Jazz Elise, you've released two tracks so far, which I want to talk about a little later on. Absolutely fantastic. Love them to bits. But you sound... When I listen to artists, I sort of get a feeling from them. And you sound like you have been doing this for ages. There's a maturity to your approach to the music, not only lyrically, but vocally as well. Your voice is extremely well-rounded. It feels like you are an established singer. And everything is just really, really good quality around what you are doing. So for me, you come across very established already, even though you've only done two tracks. I mean, where did this musical journey all start for you, Jazz? How long ago? What has got you to this point? Did you train? Tell for the listeners at home, tell us your life story when it comes to music, Jazz, please.
Well, being here in Jamaica, coming from Jamaica, most of us singers will tell you we start singing in church, in a school. You know that, so that's not new to me, so that's definitely where I started singing, just in church, on the choir, at home, before every grace, every, you know what I mean, every devotion at school. And but it was just singing for singing's sake, you know, just the passion of it, nothing else more so than that. And then I think as my life, you know, go on up in the years a little bit, I realized that, yo, this is actually a talent where we just hide under a rock. You know, that's something we say, okay, hide your talents under a rock. And about a year and a half ago, I decided to just take it serious and not just sing for myself and sing in the bathroom kind of vibe. You know, let me just do this. And I started going to studio and just vibing and recording a lot, just and trying and experimenting. And then voila, For You come about, and then Fresh and Clean.
That is excellent. And you're right, actually. That is what I hear from so many Jamaican artists. It all kind of quite often starts off in church for them, singing in the choir, and then it kind of progresses from there. And it's always great to hear, because to me, I always get the impression there's so much opportunity in Jamaica to be able to follow, if you have a musical dream, to be able to follow it. I hear it from so many artists, and it's so good to hear. So I think it's a lot harder in the UK, you know, actually. There's not the collective that artists have in Jamaica, where so many artists work together and support each other, and it's not like that over here. And it's always so good to hear that kind of story. And as you quite rightly pointed out, it came about, your first track was For You. I want to talk a bit about the tracks, because they are absolutely excellent. So you started off with For You, which was this brilliant kind of dancehall vibe going on with it. It was bang 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 up to date. But what impressed me the most was that you did this effortless flipping between this really brilliant sort of on fire Sing Jay, and then also then flipped it into these effortless vocals. And Sing Jay is not the easiest thing to do, and you do it just like it's a walk in the park for you. And that kind of approach sort of sums up your vocal style as well. You're really, it seems effortless. You're really sort of, it's very easy to listen to you. It's like there's no hardship involved with you singing. It's done perfectly. And like I say, For You was brilliant kind of dancehall feeling track. And then you've mashed it up a bit with your latest track, which is Fresh and Clean, which is this bang up to date kind of, it's got real distinct tinges of Afrobeat, which is sort of the sound at the minute. It's huge in this country. I'm real big sound at present, and again it displays your vocal skills brilliantly. You do these complex rhyming patterns, the majority of it is singing complex rhyming patterns. You do these really complex riffs as well throughout, really quick on point riffs, very intricate as well. It's vocally excellent. But what also stood out for me about Fresh and Clean was that the production is top quality on this. The people you're working with are absolutely brilliant, because I get sent a lot of music, and it's from brilliant artists sometimes who are vocally superb and on point. Quite often the production lets them down. It's either overproduced or there's too much compression going on, but Fresh and Clean, it's just spotless. It's absolutely wonderful, and I think it's an absolutely brilliant track, and I'm pleased to see it's got quite a few views on YouTube. It's been doing really well. So I mean, brilliant from you. You're absolutely amazing already in your two tracks, and so I think you're destined for big things, Jazz. I think it's going to be very, very exciting to watch you. Now, Fresh and Clean, I've seen sort of chatter on social media about what the real meaning is about it, because you kind of, there's sort of references to your spirituality in it. What's Fresh and Clean all about, Jazz? Tell the listeners at home.
All right, so firstly, more say, can you mention the production? I have to big up JLL, because JLL produced both of those tracks. Me and him in studio, we sit down and we vibe, and that's how we come up with both of them. So for you to mention the production quality of it, it really speaks volumes to me, because that's the hours in the studio, you know? That's the hours and the hours and the mixing and the mastering and everything.
Yeah, so it's really, really strong. Really, really strong production.
Mm-hmm. So Fresh and Clean. Man, Fresh and Clean is literally one of those songs where I was feeling a vibe. I was just feeling good. I was feeling confident. And I did just get a nice boost up from one of my sisters in them. Like one of those emotional confidence boosters, and I just went straight to JLL. I went to the studio and I just dropped it. And it's really just about feeling your best, encouraging people around you to feel their best and to just put their best foot forward. And no matter what obstacles you might face, you still can look yourself in the mirror and say, you know, so I'm ready. I'm fresh and I'm clean. My heart clean. I'm giving thanks. I'm blessed. And you can step out and be a day the same way, no matter any other challenges that you might face. And even in verse 2, now when we talk about that, we're kings and queens with no crowns. It's like you have nothing around here and walk around, and we really feel hopeless. We don't feel like we're worth a lot. And it's just a reminder to each and every one of us that even though the gold crown is not on our head, we're still kings, we're queens, we're worthy of experiencing this life and doing the best that we can in life. So that's it's about enough things, you know, but at the end of it, it's just loving yourself and being confident and encouraging other people to feel the same way.
That's a brilliant summing up, and that completely comes across from the track when you sort of drill down and listen to it. And like I say, I mean, it's absolutely brilliant, brilliant, brilliant track. Both your songs, they've also, as I said, they're musically kind of very different styles. For you, sort of bordered along dancehall lines, and then Fresh and Clean is kind of this Afrobeat sound. Are you musically diverse? Is your sort of love of music very broad, from reggae to soul to dancehall to R&B to what? Are you sort of diverse musically, and is that going to reflect in more material that's going to come out from you? Are we going to see sort of, are we going to see a soul jazz, as it were?
You never know. Well, I know, but you don't know. But yeah, I love a lot of music. I listen to a lot of music. My foundation, I'll tell everybody this, my foundation and my roots is dancehall and reggae 100%, because I'm born and grew in Jamaica. This is where I live. This is where I get most of my energy from. So everything will always have reggae, dancehall, inspiration and roots. More songs will sound more reggae than others, and some will sound more dancehall, and some will sound more fusion, but I just did not want to limit myself. I went to the studio and just recorded a bag of, like, just whatever was inside and whatever I felt at the time, and I allowed myself to experiment. So I guess that's where the fusion is coming from in the music, but it wasn't anything conscious, like a conscious effort to put out fusion. It's literally just the vibe and what I felt in the studio. And yeah, this is the time to just do what you feel like. I believe this is that time in our history where everybody's just speaking from the heart, and we're just like, do what we want to do, especially as women. I know you mentioned that, not to jump the gun.
It's fine.
But yeah, you can look forward to, you're going to hear some more reggae tracks, then you're going to hear some dancehall, then you're going to hear some fusion.
Excellent. That sounds absolutely great. It's a, you keep mentioning, I'm just going to sort of go off script here. You keep mentioning going into the studio and sort of having the vibe and going with that vibe. I had Jamil on last week. He was on, and I was chatting to him about the recording process with him, and he says as well, literally, he doesn't use pen and paper, as it were. He literally goes into the studio, sits with his producers, either here's a rhythm or here's some chord sequences, and then the track just kind of produces and composes itself almost.
Yeah.
Is that very similar to you? Is that the process for you when you're doing tracks?
For me, it's sometimes a process. So I have a unique relationship with JLL. I can mention him because we did a lot of stuff from scratch. So my process with that sometimes is having a melody, sometimes having a lyric written down, and then I come to him, and then from that he'll get inspiration, and then we'll bounce back and forth. So I have that process as well. But then also I have the process where I hear a rhythm, and I just go in front of the mic, and because I work with other producers as well, and I just drop some melodies and drop some vibes, and then I go home and maybe write to the melodies. So it's a whole heap of things, but the vibe is very important for me, because for me that's where the purest energy comes from, that I hope will translate to anyone that listen to it. You know, it comes from the purest place when the vibe is just there.
No, and it absolutely translates in your music. You're spot on. I mean, you kind of, as I said earlier, you tick a lot of boxes in terms of that you're an extremely good vocalist, fire sing Jay, and obviously you are a very good songwriter and lyricist as well. I mean, who musically has influenced you over the years? Does anyone, do you know what? I always feel a bit kind of edgy asking this question, because I don't know if people are going to be insulted whether they're going to say, no, I'm my own artist, of course. And no one's influenced me musically, but I always like to ask, I mean, who has influenced you musically over the years? Is there anyone, or are you just Jazz Elise and that's it?
No, we exist in the world, you know, so even if we don't know it naturally, I feel like the people you listen to and the people you love the most and respect the most musically is going to influence you somewhat. I don't even, I more could tell you who I respect and love and just listen to all the time from growing up. You know, like Whitney Houston and Mariah Carey and Beyonce and Rihanna. Like, Rihanna is a Caribbean one, so naturally I listen to her. But, you know, going into the Jamaican sphere, you know, you have Marcia Griffiths and Judy Moore, Queen Afrika, and Itana. Like, those are the women who musically really inspire me, among others. Okay, you know, everybody have them vibe and them flavor. But, yeah, those are the women I grew up listening to. And I don't know if... I feel like I am me, so I probably can't hear the influence, but maybe someone on the outside would. But those are the women that I listen a lot to musically.
Yeah, you know, I'm gonna say actually, you said Whitney and Mariah. You can hear the influence in your voice with, again, back to what I was saying about Fresh and Clean and these sort of complex, intricate running riffs that you do vocally. Now you've said that, I can hear Mariah. But then you do it really in your own way, because Mariah Carey's riffs when she does. I'm a huge Mariah Carey fan, by the way, so my eyes lighted up when you said her. So I might go on for about 10 minutes here. when Mariah Carey does her vocal riffs, they're quite often sort of really powerful and powerhousing, kind of strong. And yours are just, you do them effortlessly. There's really intricate riffs, but they're just really kind of almost as if they're just rolling out of your mouth. And you don't really have to try, but they're always perfect. And you're kind of different. It's almost like you've taken inspiration from singers like Whitney and Mariah, and then you've blended it into your very own unique style. So you can hear it, absolutely. So it's quite interesting you hear saying that. What you can also hear in your music is the fact you are obviously a conscious artist. There's a lot of talk in both tracks about the sort of hints to sort of spirituality and your faith and your worldview as well, which I think is really, really, really important. I mean, Does your spirituality and your worldview and your faith, does it influence your music, and is it going to influence sort of the direction you're going to take, do you think, or is it a kind of another part of the whole picture of Jazz Elise?
It's just a part of me. Like, if I'm being true to myself as an artist and as a person, there's no way I cannot say me wake up and give thanks. You know what I mean? Because for me, that's a source of my strength, and that's an important part of who I am, and as you said, my worldview. So I wouldn't even look at it too tough and study it too hard. It's legit just me, you know. It's just something I value, so just have to be true to myself with that one.
No, absolutely, and I think if it's a part of you, then as you say, it's important to include it. You can't deny it. But no, I think that will is reflected in your music already. There's elements of sort of consciousness in there, but you can still bruck out to your tunes, which is perfect.
Hey.
Exactly, perfect
course.
Mix. Perfect.
Have a good time.
And you also, just to big you up even more, you fit into this movement for me of female artists that are coming up and around and to the side of the whole revival movement at the minute. I'm really always humbled, and I'm really privileged to be able to constantly have loads of female artists on this show, because I think there's something really special going on. And it started, the person who sparked this in my head was Zia Benjamin. I had her on months ago, and we were chatting away. Mm-hmm. And we kind of talked about the revival movement, and she was like, well, there is a revival movement, but no one's talking about the fact there's also a whole collective of female artists coming through as well, who are breaking industry norms. They're sort of making sure they're steering away from the sort of misogyny that's always existed, and they're doing things in a different way, and they're doing them supporting each other, and breaking down these stereotypical sort of values that the music industry has on women, and they're helping each other, and they're not working like there's going to be one female artist who's going to be the queen of the revival movement, or etc. And I think she made a really, really important point, and it's hardly ever discussed, because there are so many female artists now. So you've got yourself, you've got Zia Benjamin, you've got Lila Ike, you've got Savannah, you've got Aza Lineage, you've got Ray Nicole, you've got Crying Chrissy, you've got Sharita, you've got, I could go on and on and on and on.
Yeah.
Just all these brilliant female artists who are breaking the industry norms and doing it for themselves. I mean, do you think it's sort of a divine, it's almost intervention that this is happening now, or is it because the time is now right, because we had the whole Me Too movement a few years ago? Or is it just that it's a case of, no, enough is enough, we're going to now totally reshape how female musicians are viewed within the whole movement? Why do you think there's so many female artists coming through now and starting to be at the top of their game?
I could not tell you.
That's a good enough answer.
I could not tell you, honestly, because my reality is being female. You know, that's my reality. So for me, I've always been seeing females. I've always been seeing women, and whether or not they were at the pinnacle of their careers or they were in front of a lot more people, but I've always been seeing women, and that has always been, I've always championed that. We're women, so with every opportunity a man get, we surely must can get the same opportunity, if not more, you know. But I'm sure that there are a lot of social factors that influence it. Like, we can't deny the Me Too movement, and I don't know what sparked the Me Too movement. Maybe it's just divine timing or whatever. But however, whatever the reason is, I just believe it should come to the place where it's no longer an anomaly, you know. It should be, oh, woman. Just like how we not say, oh, come so much man artists there, but we not say that. Even though there's enough male artists are around the place. But if we reach a place where we just see one woman pop up and the next woman pop up, and it is so commonplace that it is the norm. You know, so I don't subscribe to the view that, oh, only one woman can run things and this. No, every woman can eat a food. If every man artist out there is making money and is surviving and supporting their family and fulfilling their purpose being an artist, any amount of female artists can do it.
No, I think it's a brilliant summing up. And you made a really, really good point in there that about how it shouldn't be that, oh, there's a new female artist out. Shock, shock, shock. That it should just be the norm. And I think you've kind of hit the nail on the head there. And hopefully that's where we're sort of getting towards being at now. That, well, it's not that, oh, well, this is a shock. There's a female artist out there who smokes the herb, is Rasta, and is talking about conscious issues. This is just the norm, and this is how it is, in the same way it's the norm for male artists. So I think you made an excellent point there. It's really, really interesting.
Of course, of course, of course. And as you mentioned, some wonderful, amazing female artists. Like, yeah, if Leela put out a song right now, I'm going to post it, I'm going to share it, I'm going to listen it. And that is just what it should be. Same for Sev, same for Naomi, same for every other female artist who's been doing it and who's doing it. No, it's music, you know, at the end of the day for me. Music is leading the way, and it don't matter the gender or the person that's pushing the music. As long as it reaching souls and it touch people's lives and, you know, everybody enjoy themselves, like, everybody can do them thing.
I think you go, that was a brilliant answer. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Really well summed up as well. Just to wrap up, Jazz, I could go on for hours with you, actually. We could just talk and talk about all sorts of things, but we have to wrap up. I mean, what is in store for the rest of 2019 and early 2020 for Jazz Elise? I'm hoping you're going to tell me EP or album, please. Are we going? Mm-hmm. Yes.
Definitely, EP is coming, no worry yourself, but myself will keep pushing for Shan Clean and have some other music lined up. And Protege is releasing a rhythm, and myself, Savannah, Leela Aiken, Naomi Cohen have songs on that rhythm, so I'm looking forward to that. Now I say no more about that, because I don't know if I said too much. But yeah, that's coming out within the year. But just more music and more vibes, more things, man. Trust me, you can't get tired of hearing music. It's going to come.
Excellent. Yes, thank you for that exclusive, Jazz. Lovely. That sounds absolutely excellent. I cannot wait for you to release an EP. I'm going to be so, so excited to hear that. Jazz, I think you're absolutely amazing. You're great to interview as well. Lovely, brilliant. But absolutely fantastic. As I said, you're a stunning, stunning vocalist, and the production and songwriting is top quality on both your tracks. So I cannot wait to see what else you have in store for us, because I think it's going to be mind-blowing. But will you come back on the podcast when you release your EP, please?
Absolutely. A strong yes for me.
Excellent. But for the minute, Jazz Elise, thank you so much for coming on the podcast. It's been a real treat to speak to you.
Thanks for having me. Blessings.
Another Topple Uncaged podcast, another exciting artist on the show. She was great, Jazz Elise. Loved speaking to her, full of energy and really, really, really interesting and important points, especially about the movement of female artists that are coming out of Jamaica and the US around the revival movement. But fantastic. One to watch is Jazz Elise, in my opinion. And here is her latest track for you to hear. Absolutely blinding bit of Afrobeat. It's a real treat to be able to play it for you. This is Fresh and Clean. Jazz Elise, Fresh and Clean. Check this out.
Fresh and clean, fresh and clean. Fresh and clean, fresh and clean. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Someone want me step on the scene. Oh, I'm so blessed and free. Rebel want me step on the scene. Oh, I'm so fresh and clean. From my open my eyes, give thanks to the Most High. Give thanks, giving thanks for life. No stress, no stress in my side. So when you come around, you can't hold me down. You can't kill me with no attack. Whoa, try your best, my life not stress. Just a whole vibe and ease back. You got to be a rebel. Keep your mind right, meditate for good measure. Read the Psalms a day to chase away the devil. Keep your heart clean so your days can be better. You got to be a rebel. You have to leave on a rebel. Oh, you got to be a go-getter. If you really wanna take it to another level. Fresh and clean, fresh and clean. Fresh and clean, fresh and clean. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Someone want me step on the scene. Oh, I'm so blessed and free. Someone want me step on the scene. Oh, I'm so fresh and clean. The half that has never been told. We are kings and queens with no crown. We hail from a legacy renown. Just check your skin tone. Daddy fresh, mommy fresh. All of my siblings and friends fresh. JLL fresh, mic check. So when we step out, we ready and blessed. Oh yeah. We are kings and queens. We are kings and queens. We are fresh and clean. We are fresh and fresh. We are kings and queens. We are kings and queens. We are fresh and clean. We are fresh and clean.
Fresh and clean. Fresh and clean.
And that's it. Another special episode of Topple Uncaged is done. I'd like to thank my fantastic guest, the incredible Jazz Elise. Follow her on Twitter. It's at Jazz Elise JA. As always, behind the scenes, thank you to the love of my life, the gorgeous Nicola Jeffrey. Follow her on Twitter. It's at Nicola C. Jeffrey. My man behind the booth, sound engineer Gav Pauls. Follow him on Twitter. It's at Pauls with his E Radio. And my in-house singer, it's Ray Star Music. Follow her on Twitter. It's at Ray_Star113. Thank you to the Canary for uncaging me. I will see you again soon.
Uncaged.